liquid nitrogen, negative 195.79 Celsius. Physical movement or brain function, not detected. Subject status, stable. Dagger still stuck in the sheath. Inspection 481 complete. Requesting a higher power outlay for the isolation chamber to prevent any further outages. What's that? Secure me, breach. Secure me, breach.
Well, it's good to see another face. I thought I was on my own. And you're a metahuman, too. I don't know who you are, but I know what you are. You awakened the cradle, and that's something only a metahuman could do. Do you remember who you are? It must have been that fluctuation just now. It trapped me in the cradle. It could have robbed you of your memories. You can call me V. It seems that our interests are aligned, metahuman. I came to secure a deviation, a paper butterfly. But I think something must have scared it. Right now, though, we need to move. I can show you the way out of this place, but only if you help me complete my mission first. All you have to do is listen to what I tell you. I'll be right here in the cradle. Now let's go. This is a life form that has been infected with Stardust. It's called a deviant. Our world has been overrun with deviants ever since Starfall. Ordinary humans can't take high levels of Stardust exposure. When they do, you should be fine. In fact, if the conditions are right, you might even be able to use Stardust to your advantage. is Victor Hammond. What's your name?
I don't know. I just know I'm a monster. My mom, my dad, they're gone. It was all my fault.
Hey. Try and stay calm. I'm here to help you.
No one can help me. It would be better for everyone if I just leave me alone, please.
I'm afraid I can't do that. And you're not a monster. In fact, you're very, very special. You just need to learn how to control your own strength. Once you do that, you can help fix this broken world. We can do that together.
My butterfly. It's flying.
Yes. Your first deviation. And look how gentle it is.
I remember my name now. It's Mitsuko. It means child of light. It's my first creation. I will create more.
Them to forge a new path. This will be the Mayfly's mission. This is why we'll fight.
Mayflies?
That's right. Mayflies. Small, yet invincible. Reach out your left hand. See if you can feel the rhythm of it. Then try and secure it. Yes, and look what I found. A Meta, only just woken up. They were kind enough to activate the cradle and set me free.
Thank you, Meta-human. This means a lot to me. You can call me Mitsuko. I used to be a Meta-human as well. Rosetta did all kinds of experiments on me. That is, until V saved me.
Mitsuko is a very special Meta. She can sense even the tiniest fluctuations in the Stardust. It's thanks to her that I was able to take refuge in this place after Starfall. You're safe here.
Yes, an emissary of sorts. I wanted it to help rescue other Metas. The recent fluctuation must have startled it. The important thing right now is to secure it. See that thing in the center of the room? It's a device for securing deviations. This makes them more useful and safer to be around. The butterfly has recovered. I think it likes you. Deviations can be very dangerous if not taken care of. They can radiate stardust, which can lead to all kinds of unpredictable consequences. This is why we created the Mayflies. We make cradles and securement units to keep deviations contained. We're trying to find ways for humans and deviations to live in harmony. We figure this is our best chance of cleaning up the mess that Rosetta made.
No one's exactly sure what they are, just that they're not bound by the physical laws of our world. They came from another dimension, something we call rift space. When deviations get stressed, they release stardust. We think this brings our world and rift space closer together. Like with Starfall, sometimes it becomes possible to pass between the two planes of existence, and when that happens, all hell breaks loose.
Some deviations are friendly, like the butterfly. But others, like the ones inside monoliths, are extremely dangerous. It's not practical to secure all of them, of course. But if we can learn more about them, maybe we can find ways to live alongside them. That's the goal. Also, the stardust just keeps spreading, and we aren't sure why.
Shit, it must have gotten through. Come on, Meta. A deviation from another world just entered this space and it won't go down without a fight. Take the butterfly with you. It can help.
siren. So strong. Summon the butterfly. It will fight alongside you. Now you'll see for yourself what it's capable of.
Escaped.
Just driving it away was enough. And it's all thanks to you, Meta.
You're tougher than you look. That's twice now you've saved me. Yes. Mitsuko created this rift space. A refuge from the dangers of the physical world. Or so we thought.
Do you think that deviation will come back?
It's possible. We just can't sit here and wait, though. Meta, will you go back to the physical world with me?
Take the butterfly with you. Put it in your cradle. That way, I can lend you some of my strength. Hopefully, we'll meet again one day. It looks like this is goodbye. Before you go, if you have any questions, I can try and answer them for you.
No one's exactly sure what they are.
Good luck.
Just that they're not bound by the physical laws of our world. When deviations
they came from another dimension, they released Stardust,
something we call Rift Space.
We think
this brings our world and Rift Space closer together. Like with Starfall, sometimes it becomes possible to pass between the two planes of existence. And when that happens, all hell breaks loose.
About 20 years ago, Rosetta triggered a major stardust fluctuation during one of their experiments. As a result, some great ones slipped through, entering into our world. They brought increased levels of stardust with them. That poison has seeped into every corner of our world now, spawning countless deviants and other dangers. That's what Rosetta does. At first, they just locked deviations away. But then they figured out that deviations could be harnessed to make humans stronger. That's when they started their experiments, in the name of human progress, creating metahumans like me and you. To Rosetta, we are the future.
And they're not wrong. Metahumans are mankind's last hope. We were created by Rosetta, but we don't take orders from them anymore. We left. We call ourselves the Mayflies now, and we do things differently.
Good luck, Meta.
20 years after Starfall, and the world is still infested with Stardust. It looks like the monoliths here have been reactivated too. They might hold the key to all this Stardust pollution. Nice work. I've managed to unlock some memetics for Mitsuko. If you access them through your cradle, you'll be able to craft and build what we need. with memetics, you still won't be able to craft anything out of thin air. We'd better gather some ore and logs. We also need a furnace and a disassembly bench to process the materials we gather. use the furnace to refine raw materials into something more practical. We'll need it for advanced items. This is a strong foundation for us to build upon. I've set up a journey interface to help track our progress. For each task you complete, you'll unlock some supplies we can use. So far, what we've got won't do much against those deviants out there. We need proper weapons and armor. There are some abandoned Rosetta facilities nearby. Maybe we could find some useful supply crates there. I've marked their locations on your map.
Thank you. Get your hands off my stuff. You're pretty cocky for someone who doesn't even have a weapon. Hold on. Is that a cradle on your back?
Interesting. I thought I was the only Mayfly left.
I'm Mary. I came here to investigate a deviation that's been causing issues. I think it's connected to a recently reopened monolith nearby. Don't tell me you're going to try and take on a powerful deviation barehanded. Even an ordinary deviant could tear you apart right now. For a Mayfly, you're pretty inexperienced, aren't you? I'm going to give you a blueprint. Use it to make yourself a gun. While you're doing that, I have other matters to attend to. Once you're done, come find me in Deadsville. It's the nearest survivor settlement. We can plan our next steps from there. After all, two heads are better than one.
So another Mayfly survived, yet I can't remember her. My memory's been patchy ever since Mitsuko revived me. Just to be safe, it's better not to share everything we know with that woman. Especially about Mitsuko. That blueprint is rock solid, though. We can use it to make a real gun. Let's check your memetics and start by building a gear workbench. This assembly bench will let you take objects you've scavenged and break them down into useful materials.